Hey! So, my name is Sarah Spear. I have been here since the beginning. I was a camper back in 2005. And so I'm sort of Amy's second in command. So she told me to stall, so I'm stalling. So the objective was to find someone who could talk, or I was going to start telling music jokes. So I'm going to start telling music jokes. Just so we know that this is all in good humor, we're going to start with my instrument. How do you call a baritone player? Euphonium! No? Okay. And we'll move on to my next instrument. What's the range of a tuba? A couple yards with a good arm. Now, what's the difference between a tuba and a euphonium? A couple dollars in scrap metal. Alright, moving on. How do you get two piccolo players to play in unison? You make one of them stop playing. Alright, fine. We can do that. Two snare drums and a cymbal fall off a cliff. Ba-dum-tsh. What do you call two oboe players playing in unison? A minor second. How do you know it's a clarinet player who's driving a certain car? They have the domino symbol on top. What do you call a group of saxophones at the bottom of the ocean? A good start. How many trumpet players does it take to change a light bulb? One. They hold it up and the world revolves around them. How do you make a trombone sound like a French horn? You put your hand in the bell and play all the wrong notes. So I told this next one to a violinist whose dad actually played trombone, only I didn't realize it, like I didn't remember it at the time when I told them, and it's sort of a true story. How do you know a trombone player's kid on the playground? They don't know how to use the slide and they can't swing. How many second violins does it take to change a light bulb? We don't know. They can't get up that high. What's the difference between a violin and a viola? We're not sure. We think they're the same. It's just the violinist's head is so big with their ego that the viola looks bigger. let's see. What's a good cello joke? I mean, it's a cello. This is a harsh one, and I'm sorry. I try not to encourage violence towards instruments. But what's the difference between a bass and a trampoline?
You take your shoes off to jump on a trampoline.
Good job. I'm hoping I don't have to stall much longer, but I'm going to go on to conductors. How many conductors does it take to change a light bulb? We're not sure. No one's ever seen them. No one ever watches. All right, let's see. All right, I guess we're moving on to funny stories. So I was teaching percussion class this one time, and it was at camp, music camp, a couple years ago. And I hold up a piece of metal that has three angles on it. And I asked them, what's this? And the resounding answer was, it's a square. And I'm like, really? And they're like, no, it's a circle. I'm like, really? It was a triangle. a bassoon player told me this one. We'll go back to jokes. What are burning oboes used for?
Fire.
Setting bassoons on fire. And like I said, I don't encourage violence towards instruments. I really don't. Like, you can ask people who have known me. I used to play my instrument with gloves because I didn't want to get fingerprints on it. I am that protective. So don't actually hurt your instrument. That's a bad idea. I don't know. Someone give me an instrument. Okay, so the second violin joke works with the altos. How many altos does it take to change a light bulb? We don't know. They can't get up that high. Timpani. A timpani joke. Oh, that's a good one. I mean, I could Google them. Tell me about the drummer that locked his keys in the car.
It took 2 hours to get him out.
Okay, I have another one. What's the difference between a piano player and a pie of pizza? The pie of pizza can feed a family of four. Alright, so you're driving along, and there's a guitarist, and he's not doing so well. And then there's a squirrel, and he's, like, dead. But what's the difference? There are skid marks in front of the squirrel. Don't hurt people either. Bad idea. Piccolo. I already did a piccolo joke. A ukulele? Okay. Again with the squirrel, and it's a ukulele this time instead of guitar player. But what's the, like, besides the skid marks, what's the difference?
The ukulele.
The ukulele player, or sorry, the squirrel was probably on his way to a gig.
Flute?
Yeah. Why do you never see flute players breathe? They have so much room in their head to store all the air. Alright, where is Elise Chappelle? There she is. This is her favorite joke. So I'm telling this one in honor of her. So in this alternate universe, there's like a butcher shop. And out front, he has a sign with all the meats that he's selling. And he has flutes for flute player brains for like $4 a pound. Which, okay, whatever. And then he has, what's a good instrument? Okay, fine. He has violin player brains for like $6.50 a pound. And then he has bass clarinet player brains for like $20 a pound. And so the person walks in and they're like, why are bass clarinet player brains so expensive? And the butcher responds, do you know how many bass clarinet players you have to kill to get a pound of brain? All right, Amy, how much longer do I have to stall? Okay, who has one?
Minnie.
Go ahead, Mason.